Significance of glutamine. In brain, conversion of glutamate to glutamine, you know that glutamate is containing ammonia, and glutamate to glutamine is a major detoxification mechanism, removing ammonia from the brain tissue. ठीक है, ग्लूटामेट जो है वो ब्रेन में सारी अमोनिया से कंबाइन करता है, ठीक है, एंड देन ट्रांसफर इट टू द फॉर्म ऑफ ग्लूटामीन टू द ग्लूटामीन. द अमोनिया इज ट्रांसपोर्टेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ग्लूटामीन. ग्लूटामीन इज नॉन टॉक्सिक कंपाउंड, न्यूट्रल कंपाउंड, एंड कैन ईजली क्रॉस द मेम्ब्रेन एज कंपेयर टू द ग्लूटामेट being bearing the negative charge. You know that glutamate, it carries a negative charge. It is an acidic amino acid, and therefore it is not easy for the charged molecules to cross the membrane. Whereas glutamine is non-toxic, neutral compound, and can easily cross the membrane. Glutamine has a highest plasma concentration of 0.6 millimole per liter, and two amino groups are stored per molecule of ammonia in the glutamine molecule. अब लिवर में पहुंच के क्या होगा? ग्लूटामीन तो कुछ नहीं कर सकता, वो तो यूरिया में कन्वर्ट नहीं हो सकता. सो अगेन the enzyme glutaminase, it will release ammonia from the glutamine, and ammonium ion is toxic. अभी आपने देखा अमोनिया आपको NH3 कहीं नहीं नजर आया होगा, अमोनियम आयंस नजर आए होंगे. इज टॉक्सिक इफ अलाउड टू accumulate इन द बॉडी, therefore इट इज hydrolyzed. इसमें से एक H आयन निकल जाता है, इट इज hydrolyzed टू फॉर्म अमोनिया, which is gaseous and difficult to accumulate. So the accumulation of NH4 is easy, it is toxic, and therefore it is hydrolyzed and ammonia is released. You know that gases are difficult to accumulate, whereas the non-gaseous form, it is easy to accumulate. So it is hydrolyzed, and then the ammonia which is released, it is converted into urea. तो इसका process क्या हुआ कि glutamate से glutamine बना, glutamine से ने ये ammonia release की, and ammonium ions release किए, and the NH4 form is hydrolyzed. ये आप देखें. Glutamine, it releases the ammonium ion. Ammonium ions, they are hydrolyzed to form NH3, and NH3 is converted into urea, and in turn with the help of the glutaminase enzyme, this is converted into glutamate. ठीक है, तो glutamate, glutamine, glutamate, urea. चार स्टेप्स हैं. अगर हम समरी लें तो हमने स्टार्ट की थी स्टोरी ग्लूटामेट से. ग्लूटामेट इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्लूटामीन बिकॉज ग्लूटामीन इज अ नॉन टॉक्सिक कंपाउंड, इट कैन इजली कैरी द अमोनियम आयंस, एंड देन अगेन ग्लूटामीन इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्लूटामेट टू रिलीज द NH4. दिस NH4 is hydrolyzed, it forms the NH3. This NH4 is also toxic. Why it is toxic? Because it can accumulate anywhere. So it is converted into NH3. NH3 is present in the gaseous form, and it is not toxic. It does not accumulate. It is present in the gaseous form, NH3, and it will not accumulate. And NH3 is then converted into urea. Actually, not the NH4, it is the NH3. Agar aap urea cycle dekho, so it is the NH3 which is converted to urea. NH4 is hydrolyzed. Ammonia produced in the liver enters the urea cycle. In the kidneys, ammonia produced by glutaminase is excreted in urine and it also serves as a buffer. ठीक है, अमोनिया आपको पता है, आप लोग रीनल मॉड्यूल जो सबसे पहला मॉड्यूल था उसमें पढ़ चुके हो कि इट ऑल्सो एक्ट एज अ बफर. जो बफरिंग एक्शन था ऑफ अमोनिया बाय द किडनीज उसमें आपने पढ़ा होगा एंड द अमोनिया इज ऑल्सो एक्सक्रीटेड इन यूरिन. So, I am not dealing with the urea formation because it has already been discussed in the GIT module. Hyperammonemia kya hota hai? Sabse pehle hota hai acquired. In case of liver cirrhosis due to hepatitis or biliary obstruction, portal blood is shunted directly into circulation and does not have access to liver. Detoxification of ammonia by urea formation is impaired and thus ammonia level is elevated. Acquired. Why we say it is acquired? It is due to liver cirrhosis. In liver cirrhosis, you know that in the liver ammonia formation takes place. So in liver cirrhosis, ammonia formation does not take place. And the ammonia level is elevated. Genetical दूसरी type होती है, ये तो मैंने आपको acquired बताई जो कि liver की वजह से होती है, hepatitis हो जाए या liver cirrhosis हो जाए, so hyperammonemia में result. दूसरा होता है genetical, that is enzymes of the urea cycle are absent. Then we come to the nervous tissue, chemical composition of the nervous tissue. Nervous tissue is characterized by high lipid and protein content. Ye yaad rakhna. Theek hai? We have finished the ammonia and now we start with the nervous tissue. And nervous tissue is characterized by high lipid and protein content. कौन कौन से लिपिड होते हैं? फॉस्फोलिपिड होते हैं, स्फिंगोफॉस्फोलिपिड होते हैं, अनएस्टेरिफाइड कोलेस्ट्रॉल होता है. जब हम अनएस्टेरिफाइड कोलेस्ट्रॉल की बात करते हैं, इट मींस दैट द इट इज नॉट कंबाइंड विद एनी अदर एसिड, फैटी एसिड्स. इट इज नॉट कंबाइंड विद द फैटी एसिड. And it is present in the simple form, unesterified form. Myelin sheath. Most of the lipids of the nervous system are found around the myelin sheath and account for about 70-80% of the myelin dry mass. यानी 70-80% जो myelin sheath का mass होता है या weight होता है वो 70-80% लिपिड्स की वजह से होता है. सो लिपिड्स एंड प्रोटीन दे आर प्रेजेंट इन लार्ज अमाउंट इन द माइलिन शीट. व्हाट इज माइलिन? इट इज अ प्रोटीन विच इज प्रेजेंट इन द माइलिन शीट. द मेजर लिपिड कंस्टेंट ऑफ द माइलिन कोलेस्ट्रॉल ग्लिसरोफॉस्फोलिपिड एंड फॉस्फोलिपिड. It does not contain large amount of the saccharides. It does not contain glucose, galactose, fructose in large amount. Protein found is myelin, which is a basic protein in the nerves outside of the spinal cord. Schwann cells produce myelin. It is very important for the MCQ. Which cells? Schwann cells, they produce the myelin. ये आप देखो, ये myelin sheet है, right? And it is composed of the myelin protein. अब ये diagram बहुत important है, ये देखें, Schwann cells हैं. और ये माइलिन प्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं, माइलिन। और ये आप देखें, ये अंदर माइलिन शीट है, ये माइलिन शीट है। यहाँ पे आप देखें माइलिन शीट ये स्टार्ट हो रही है, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द माइलिन शीट, और ये कंप्लीट हो रही है, ठीक है। इनसाइड द एग्जॉन, एग्जॉन को ये कवर करती है पूरा, ये एग्जॉन को ये देखें, ये एग्जॉन है और ये इसको पूरा माइलिन शीट कवर कर रही है। एंड द एग्जॉन सॉरी श्वान सेल्स दे आर प्रोड्यूसिंग द माइलिन। What are neurons? Neurons are able to synthesize long chain fatty acids in the human body in the form of hydroxy acids. So neurons, they are able to synthesize themselves hydroxy acids that is the long chain fatty acids. Proteins, what are the functions of the proteins in nervous tissue? They serve as channels. Channels, aapko pata hai, to transport the ions. They serve as transporters, they serve as receptors, and they serve as neurotransmitters. So amino acids, you know that most of the amino acids, they serve as neurotransmitters. We'll see when we will study the neurotransmitter. All this was the basic information about the nervous tissue. So the neurons are able to synthesize the long chain fatty acids in the human body in the form of the hydroxy acids. Protein of the nervous tissue, they are important. Myelin, it plays a role in forming, or other proteins, they form other proteins in the nervous tissue. They act as channels, transporters and receptors, and the neurotransmitters. You know very well what are the receptors, what are the transporters, what are the channels. But we'll discuss the neurotransmitters.